Have you ever wanted to take any photo and just carve that into wood? In today's episode, we're going to teach a very simple technique called photo v-carving. Using Carveco Maker Plus, we're going to go over exactly how to do that and the technique used. Let's get into it. Hey guys, Jason here. In today's episode, we're going to be carving Samuel L. Jackson from my favorite movie, Pulp Fiction. If you haven't seen this movie, I don't know what planet you live on. Go see it. If we open up our Carveco Maker Plus, we're just going to start a new model. And I'm going to show you a trick to finding the perfect size. We just open up a model 20 by 20. We do need max resolution because we're working with a photograph and whatever units you're going to be working with. And when we start our model here, we're going to first import a photograph using our texture relief tool. If we open up the texture relief tool and we go to from file and we select the file and we go over here to where our photographs are. The photograph of Samuel L. Jackson that I'm using is a black and white version of the photo that I showed you guys. This photo here, I basically just used the image editor, and you can click these filters, and I believe the filter that I'm using is called denim. You can change the intensity of this filter. You can also enhance the brightness of the photo. Getting a bright, clear image is always a good practice, and then when you're happy with that, you can save it. So in Carveco, we're going to open that black and white version. And you can see the height was 20, which is the size of our box. And the width is 13.36. It gives it right here. Copy this width. And we're going to start a whole new project. And I'm going to use this width. If you just paste it in there and you hit OK, you actually have to click in the box and change a number to get this to move. Now, our box is already sized up for that photograph. So now what we're going to do is we're going to import that photograph as a relief. We click on relief. We go to import. We're going to just click on the import button here. We're going to go back to that black and white picture. And of course, it brings it in the size of the resolution that the picture was at, 1220 by 815. And the Z range is 0.98047. We're going to want to change that to fit the scale of our model. If you click this little lock button, you can maintain the aspect ratio between the width and the height. And that's basically what we want to do so that it doesn't change. We're going to change our height to 20. And notice that the width automatically came up to that perfect 13.36 that our model is already set to, using our little trick. Now when we hit apply, it happened somewhere over here. If I zoom back, it's probably it's way off. If you press F9, that'll bring the model back to the screen. And you could see, let's go back to, let's see, click on this. The Z range for these need to be very small. The two most important things about doing a photo V-carve is the original Z height of your photograph and the step over at which you cut it. The height at which you paste it down is going to determine the actual highs and lows of the V-carve. And you want this to be very small. Now, I have a magic number. Use this number, 0420. Snoop Dogg told me this number. It's like a magic number, and it brings the image down very small, but leaves it high enough to still leave some detail. Now we're going to just click add. We're going to paste that down. Now, as you can see, our model is pretty blocky from the picture. It was very pixelized. So the way you fix that is we're going to click the smooth relief tool. And we're going to smooth that down. Now you can play with the smooth relief tool strength over here. What you're basically looking for is you're just trying to get rid of the blockiness but without losing too much detail. And then once you're happy with the smoothness, we're going to hit apply. And now we have our image pasted down. So the next thing we're going to want to do is set up our toolpaths. We go to toolpath, and we're not doing a v-carve. We're actually going to do a machine relief carve. We're going to do the whole relief. We're not doing a roughing pass. We're just going to use the finishing pass. And I'm going to select a 60 degree V-bit. Now, the settings of this V-bit I have right now at a feed rate of 80, a plunge rate of 40, and my step over is a 0.04 or 8%. I have my step down at 0.25. Now, if you remember, the whole picture is 0.0420. So that means that the V-bit will be able to go to the bottom of the groove in one pass. And that's what we want. This number needs to be bigger than the depth that you pasted it down. Okay, now that we have our 60 degree V-bit selected, we want to use a roster toolpath. The roster toolpath, I prefer the classic toolpath than the advanced toolpath. Just know that the Roster Classic is a simpler toolpath, and this will go faster using the classic toolpath versus the regular Rasta toolpath. And when I do my photo V-carves, I have always found it better to use an angle, and I like 45 degrees because it's going to go across at a diagonal. And then something else that's pretty important is the tolerance. You want a pretty tight tolerance. You want at least two or three zeros in your tolerance. If we click the drop down for the bit, we get to adjust our step over rate. The first thing we're going to do is calculate the toolpath at the 0.04 step over. And then when I go to simulate that toolpath, normally this is on standard, which is 0.008 resolution. You can get a high detail simulation. For photo V carving, I actually like to use a custom resolution of 600 pixels per inch. And that's going to give you a 0.002 inches resolution. And then when you simulate that, it will take just a little bit longer, but you get a lot better representation of the actual V-carve. And then as this resolves, you can see our photo here. And if we zoom in close, you can actually see the lines that it's going to cut at the 45 degree angle. What you're looking for is how clear this picture is. If I zoom in and out, you can see that right here in the eyes, around the head here, it's pretty good, but it's not as clear as it could be. And I'm going to show you how to make adjustments. We're just going to make adjustments to our step over, and I'm actually going to go with a larger step over with a 0.05. And if we go to our simulation, we can reset that and see it again. Now, that picture a minute ago I showed you, and I wanted to show you this spot in the eyes because it's the easiest spot to see where you're getting a little bit better picture. I think we can lighten this up some more. If we go, let's just go to 0.06. And you can see that the wider the step over, the lighter the picture gets. And that's because it's giving a little bit more room for those raised areas to carry the lighter part of the picture. The closer those lines get, the darker the entire picture will get. And so it'll be a little harder to see. But you can see that our picture is looking a lot clearer. It might be just a tad too light. You can play with this. Like, we may go right in between those two, go at 5.5. And then once that renders, yes, I think that is a very clear picture. And you're ready to carve this picture on your CNC.
Okay, guys, we just finished carving the V-carve, and I did it in this piece of pecan. Sort of really hard to see that image in there. Get down at an angle, you can see it almost. Now we're just gonna paint this solid black, and we'll be back after that.
Okay, guys, I got the picture painted, and now I'm going to just sand the surface, just the high points. I'm using a 220 grit.
And there you go, guys. Samuel Jackson. Now, this piece of pecan does have a brown sort of mark through the middle. This would probably look better in a solid color piece of wood, but I'm going to cut it off at the bottom and cut it off at the top and frame it out. Guys, if you like this content, please subscribe, hit the like button, and ring the bell. That lets us know we're doing okay. Thanks, guys. Have a good one.